Greetings, friends, and welcome back to the Darkness Estate. This is Darkest Dungeon. I'm Phwop, and we just struck through the cove with not too many problems. We finished up in the dark for a little bit of extra treasure. I don't believe we have much. We want some of these sexy man busts. So this is where we're going. This is the crew I have picked out. It is an apprentice level mission. We have our level 0 Hellion. She does have sharpened spear. Oh man, let me equip that on my other Hellion before I get, okay. Whew. We've got some good camping skills. So nothing to complain about. Plenty to spend our one camp on without buying new ones. I might try Revel. I kind of hate it. But if I can get rid of that buff, that debuff somehow, it would be worth it. But if I can't, it just sucks. It is going to be a Purify. So we're going to activate 3 corrupted altars. We'll be carrying holy water with us, which will take up room in our inventory. Medium length. No one has disease, no plague doctors coming, got good heals. Note that he's even got his inspiring cry, which is, especially at higher levels, a pretty excellent little ability. You can use it from anywhere, even if he gets out of position. This is not a mobile party. But no one is completely useless from any particular position. So with good heals, I think we can manage 16 food. I want 2 shovels. I want 2 holy waters, 2 medicinal herbs, because medicinal herbs are the best. Let's bring 2 keys. We can use those on locked cabinets. What level are you guys? 1, 0, 1, 1. These guys aren't particularly OP. So we're gonna bring 8 torches. And with 135 left, I think this is plenty. Fairly well provisioned. We do kind of have to wander around. You never know when it's going to end. We do not want to adventure in the dark. Stress heal, not something we have a whole lot of. But health heal we do. So let's be about equipping trinkets. Alright, Crusader's Orders are excellent. Virtue Chance, Stress Damage, Death Blow Resistance. A little bit of Blight Bleed lack there, but whatever. Let's go with that. 15% damage from melee skills, pretty good. Hell's Hairpin, Torchlight Low, Crazy Damage. Debuff and Bleed Resistance is lacking. But I don't mind taking it. I do want stress resistance and dodge on her, as she is a baby. Do I want to adventure in the dark? On an apprentice level 1. Let's actually just put stress resistance on her. Here we have accuracy. Who has trap disarm? Nobody. In that case, let's take reduced party surprise, increase scouting and trap disarm, and then trap disarm. All right, maybe I poo-pooed this Ancestor Scandal a bit much. It is pretty darn good. We are not equipping a Tough Ring, which seems weird, so let's put it on the Crusader. He has the higher hit points, so that 15% max hit points is gonna help him out. And his damage isn't bad, so 10% is gonna be, you know, a little bit, but not too much. Plus, with his extra unholy damage, he should be fine. All right, we've got 2 on guard, 3 on guard, so we're gonna be really fast. and quite dodgy round one. So we're just going to keep the light high, and we are going to crush our way through this. Let's go. We want all to busts. Okay. Skills. Let me double check, because I did a pretty poor job of this last time. Skills. Camping. Items. That's your checklist. Besides party comp. Skeletons high protects are susceptible to blight attacks. So I do wish there were more ways to straight up overcome blight.
Can the defiled be consecrated? Can the fallen find rest?
But there's not much to do about it except DOTs. Oh man, I really hate spending a shovel right here.
Even the cold stone seems bent on preventing passage.
But I guess we will. There's probably nothing back here, which is really gonna piss me off. We got a scout, which I won't say no to. It will help us avoid another tunnel, but we get ambushed for our troubles. Ambushed by foul invention. Now see, if I had breakthrough here, this would be the perfect time. As is, let's yawn. Wow. Okay, what I meant was...
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them all.
This one does more damage. And puts the kibosh on its damage. Aha! Sucker!
Their formation is excellent. Broken. Maintain the offensive.
This one, once again, does more damage.
Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles.
Okay, another medicinal herb is an excellent thing. Now, we definitely don't want to go through that blockade, nor is it worth backtracking from that curio, most likely. Unfortunately, that curio could be one of our quest things. We'll just have to deal with that. Stashed heirlooms. I was really hoping for busts. If it bleeds, this is a great attack because it does like basically it does full damage and it applies bleed, which is a little rare. It doesn't have the crit chance of the other one, but it's pretty sick, and we can probably snipe this guy. No, he will survive. He might have survived.
Give them no quarter.
Start working this guy down. So bulwark's not a bad attack, or not a bad idea, because this guy is point blank shot. He's flying fire.
Impressive.
Excellent. Just where that needed. I mean, anyone but the corpse would have been great. Oh, sadly, we did not beat this dude out, but I guess his turn was wasted. Suppression fire, we'll get rid of him. Let's reduce this guy's damage. Oh, not enough. Well, he's already acted. Oh, come now. Could have been worse. Still, he didn't need the stress. Take this, it is a much higher crit chance attack.
A victory. Perhaps a turning point.
And then let's all crit damage. A little bit of damage across the party. Wow.
this momentum. Push on to the task's end.
Very good. More obstacles. We can't avoid that one. That is going to be our last shovel. Making skipping that one all the more desirable. An extra key doesn't hurt. Particularly need a scout here, but I'll take it. Okay. He's most stressed out. He's already equipped with this trap disarming stuff. Note that he's like plus 70% up on traps, which is incredible. And I guess the base trap is 50%. Sweet, sat contents. Okay, this is a treasure room. Definitely gonna be a fight. Let's actually take this one in the dark.
And now, the darkness holds dominion.
Black, and we'll probably camp afterwards. But I want this sweet loot in the dark. And camping will restore whatever stress we get. Thankfully, we were not surprised. We can hack this thing. We do have a chance to kill it outright. It is immune to our bleed, so we lose quite a bit. We have less than a 50% chance of killing it outright. Or we can just stun these first two and save ourselves some serious damage. Damage isn't so bad, stress is bad. Sadly. Ah. She's exactly the least stress resistant in my crew. But we did pile her down with stress resistant stuff. Note that we did take a ton of physical damage for our troubles. Excellent. She was one of the ones I wanted down. And I suppose. Okay, she still has her turn left. Jeez, come on. With the low damage and all.
As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms.
Okay, you might as well just hear that blight bleed, get a little bit of health. And then tell me you've got the abyssal artillery, 78% chance to hit. That's what I like. Bit of time. If it causes bleed on her, she can, of course, get that back. It's only turn three, so I don't think we'll be penalized for going all, Oh no! I raised my torchlight! What was I thinking? Kill him. Maybe we'll get a little bit of stress back. No?
Be wary. Triumphant pride precipitates a dizzying fall.
Okay, well, we can still burn that. Let's go down this hallway first. I want her to have this stress disarm. I suppose that's not to be. It's worth this jade to me. probably something I'm going to throw out anyway. Quite careful with her stress. Already looted pack. Man, I love this game. I really do. Okay, let's open this. Yes, more busts. And a jade that we might throw away like all the jades before. Now let's see. I want to peek out here. Okay, so at the edge here, we can see that it's a sack of stuff. Thankfully, it is not a quest reward, and we don't suffer any stress backtracking, which is good. We might as well wait. Our torch will just burn down as we travel over this hallway. It's only 4 points, but let's be efficient. We might as well camp here, which will of course make our party significantly more deadly and save us some torches and open up some space.
A spark without kindling is a goal without
hope. Okay, we'll have one meal left after this. I think we can handle it. String crossbow. Not that. I want extra damage on who? I think. Talk on her would go well. Massive stress reduction on him is possible. Pep talk her. If it bleeds, we can slay it. Three left. I could abandon hope and then do something else for two. Zealous Vigil, plus 10 accuracy, does not hurt at all. He's not particularly stressed out, but hey. Or he could stand tall and de-stress. Or we could revel up over here. Go with accuracy. So accuracy, damage, crit chance, stress. Pretty much what we focused on here. Things are going according to plan. I feel strong and powerful. You'll be fine.
The way is lit. The path is clear. We require only the strength to follow it.
At least we know this curio is not the one. Not the one we desperately need. Hopefully there's no more of this nonsense. Let's keep the light high in hopes of scouting. Excellent. We only need one more scout, and then we can actually drop the lights. I don't feel like coming back this way.
The match is struck. A blazing star is born.
Let's mark him this turn, and then we will lower his damage next turn. Because I believe the first thing he's going to do is summon. His stun is only 50%. Let's actually go for the stun first. Sad. Burn through him in two rounds. Are they unholy? Or they're eldritch? That thing is human? Rough. ...25% chance to crit. Blind fire, I don't know if it's really that important right now. Let's just focus on him. Yes. 30 damage crit always helps. Okay, they're protecting each other, whatever. Maybe I shouldn't even bother. Let's just wear this sucker down. Doesn't do much damage, it's all stress. These are our most stress-resistant people, so it's pretty good. Okay, we take the one out, the other one, of course, defending. If it bleeds, and in bleed it does.
Death
like, ouch!
For the slightest lapse in concentration.
Finish him. Alright, the collector goes down quite quickly. Do need to get a heal. I wonder if we can still hit both of them.
A dizzying blow
that attack
to body and brain.
Really hurts. Oh, not okay. These things, they can be bled. Its protection is intense. Stun? Good, good. There we go. Give us some time to not die or bleed. Okay, she can only restore someone else. Which means I need to use his heal on her. Five is better than zero. I'll give another go, guys. Excellent. So his protection should start dying off. Healing this guy's receiving is getting kind of intense. Oh, come now. Already acted. You can finish him off, I think. So this guy's getting 72% heal increase. Unfortunately, I just can't leave it like this. We're gonna have to we may stress out. Hopefully, if reinforcements come, they're not like, that is what I needed. Okay. Okay. We're good. It passes. Well, that's good to know. Who's got actions left? She does. Don't want to move it off just yet. She'll top herself up.
As the light gains purchase, spirits are lifted, and purpose is made clear.
Okay, and she will finish off before we risk undue stress penalties.
This expedition at least promises success.
Very rare. 25% extra damage, minus 10 hit point, plus 20% stress damage. Damage is intense. At least Dizma lives. Less health, extra stress. I could equip it right now, but I don't think I'm not aching for that extra stress. However, solid find. Let's peek out here. What is it? Are you an urn? Okay, we've got the holy water for the urn. Okay, I want the light to be high as I go up here. Have to activate 3 corrupted altars. They're probably in these rooms. I risk not being able to feed myself, which sucks. Let's go up here first and assume we're gonna clear out the whole dungeon. Okay, second thought. We have no food left. This is why I normally take way more food. Yeah. Actually, her stress resistance is pretty good. She'll probably still have to go get de-stressed after this mission, but maybe he won't if we focus on him. Urn, have some holy water urn. Give me some food, yo. Alright, whatever. We don't need to scout. We may not be long for this dungeon. I have 6 torches left.
Darkness
closes. Let's fight this in pitch black.
Haunting the hearts of men.
I would think it's almost certainly one of the altars we need. It is. Ooh, madman. Lucky us. Oh. That's rough. Can't hit the madman. Not gonna last next turn. We can snipe the other one. Ooh. Unfortunately, can't. We have to heal.
A singular strike.
Excellent strike. You know what? If we take this out, we can stun the front one. Because we won't get a chance to act. First, so it's bulwark. Sadly, that raised our light. I forgot that it does that. Alright. That may feel like a crit to you, but excellent. Okay, and we make a nice recovery here. Fish for crits. finish him off.
These nightmarish creatures can be felled. They can be beaten.
They're not food either. This jade will not stack up to a full pile of gold. Anti-venom, not so useful. Aha, in your face, Alter. Alright, so we are going to have to adventure up here somewhere. There's going to be another altar. We may unfortunately starve along the way. It seems like I pretty much always bring max food.
Terrors may indeed stalk these shadows, but yonder, a glint of gold.
Goodies, yet more of that spiteful jade. Perhaps these can be converted to food? Are you food? They're very stun resistant. The spider's not so bad. The maggots bring stun and disease and all this other stuff to the table. The spiders, not nearly as much bad stuff. Mostly damage, especially in conjunction with other spiders, but fortunately we may not have to deal with that. DD.Ep9. Let's make sure we kill this. And top ourselves off in case we starve. Makes everyone feel good. Fishing for crits. I'll just blind fire to make sure it doesn't get a turn. Take those crests.
Remind yourself that overconfidence
is
a slow and insidious killer.
You know you want to not starve. Alright, here's another dark altar.
Force of will can overcome a failing body.
That sucks. Food, I guess, is not to be found here, so I guess I suggest always taking. Always take a lot of food. Now let's not starve again, guys, because that would just be awkward. Yay, loot awaits us. These guys in the back can do so much damage. And we have some relatively squishy targets here. So let's just try and take out them as much as we can. Wow! Okay, doing pretty good here. She's a fine target for the coral, I don't mind. Let's try and patch her up. He could use a crit, this thing could use some damage debuff. She heals herself a little bit better because of the buff. He takes a serious shot, I was afraid of that. Stupid light increasing abilities. Figured we'd get rid of one torch, moving this into a weak spot for it. He should be able to heal himself. Busts and cash.
So too will
I think that
resistance.
Is enough busts for our purposes. It is pitch black, which is nice. When you go to open up one of these bad boys, you find more busts. Full stack of emeralds, nothing to complain about. Torches. I don't think we need torches. Where we're going, we don't need torches. Okay, let's peek out this door just in case there's an altar in the hallway. Okay, our poor dude's sanity here may break. She has to move forward. That buff isn't going to do her any good if she can't attack me at all. For the damage debuff on this guy, he'll be around, and his ability to act quickly and cause absolute damage. Sick. Plus, we can wipe these out pretty quick. Thank you. Yeah. I think the Hellion and Crusader can take care of that, so let's... stack this debuff in case he crits. Obviously, bleeding is not a thing.
Such a terrible assault.
Thankfully, just a
5
damage crit. Somewhat gracefully.
Success
so
clearly in view. Or is it merely a trick of the light?
Citrine. Let's go with goodies here, though. As I would prefer to bring a lot of cash home. As we're scraping the bottom of the barrel a bit hard here. And let's see what's in that last room. Okay, one more fight and one more bobble. We might starve before we get there, which will cause all sorts of freaking out. But I think most of these guys are destined to get some therapy, so I'm gonna risk it.
Those who covet injury find it in no short supply.
Masochist. So while our stress is gonna climb, I wanna get the most out of this particular adventure. That's a pretty brutal swap, guys. Okay. It's better that she do that than push the Crusader further back. If you stun her, that's gonna be such a pain.
To a killing blow.
Well, at least he's already the really stressed out one. Trapped up there. Getting nibbled by the grave. They won't push him to heart attack land. 2, 3. Let's go with blind fire since they've all acted. And it should let us go first next round. Kill, even if I don't know what I'm shooting at. Sure, see, that's why we did that. Counteract some of this stress. Tell me the fight was worth it.
A trifling victory.
Like 500.
But a victory nonetheless.
And this is the last thing. Nothing. What about trying a key? We did pick up two keys along the way. Just touch it. No, disease! Thankfully, we resist it. And we're out. Okay, we did capture all the busts we needed to upgrade our disease treatment facility. If we are lucky, it will save us about, I don't know, 1,000 every time it procs, because it should. Here, I'll probably use it when I have like 3 diseases. Eagle eye. Winded. Nothing great there. Good bit of stress.
In time, you will know the tragic extent of my failings.
Okay, what missions call? There's a boss in the cove. There's more baby quests over here. Manslayer's ring, I wouldn't complain about. Bosses that are human, not hard to come across. That hairpin, you could double up on these hairpins for some sick crit chance in the dark. And we already have holy orders. Not that stacking these would be a bad idea either. All right, so we've got a decent crew. Bonel, Bry. An excellent healing team. Who would we like to join them? Having a bounty hunter along as well would make for some serious death dealing. And then we could even have Theon in the front. One of the things is, so the occultist and arbalist healing crew are excellent with Theon, and you need, just because he prevents Vestals from coming with you, you need to really consider strongly how best to heal other members of your party. He can restore himself pretty well, but yeah, need some other people. We did get a good bit of gold from that fairly cheaply. Yay, here we are. Increase the chance of curing extra diseases. What else would I use busts on? The Abbey. No, we're fine. We're kind of, we're doing all right with stress. It's diseases that are running rampant. Do that. The diseases down here. Tapeworm does suck so hard. I hate tapeworm. And you can't cure it till after they eat with other stuff. But he needs to spend a week in town anyway. Let's get rid of the runs. service is bad. Weak grip on life is bad. We need to get someone else to level 2. So we can't take these three, and Theon and Papillon won't work together. Who would I want? This bounty hunter really is the one. But we could get Lisu up there quicker. And he's a pretty good combo with Papillon. That means we won't be needing Theon so soon. A lot of unholy creatures that cause stress damage too. Let's just get Theon in order. Oh no, we're gonna be taking level 1 missions. Let's then start working this guy out. Oh no, we're gonna take him on a level 1 mission. Yeah, that's how it's gonna go. Okay, gotta keep the strapped beds full. Note that he was brought back to 100 stress, which is nice because this will get him back in order fairly cheaply. Right, we're gonna want ready to go. Slightly better than the stun charm, but better. And what will our next mission be? Apparently it is the darkest dungeon. Alright guys, I guess I'm gonna stop here. Glad we got through this episode. Thanks for watching. I hope you appreciated it. We did starve some, so I just, you know what? On a medium or long mission, I would say always take 24 food. Especially if you're light on healers. Otherwise, don't stare at a black screen too long. I don't see how it could be downhill from here. So, I suppose this is the end of the video. Thanks for watching. Please like, subscribe if you haven't already. And remember that January 4th, we'll be launching Bleak House, which is going to be kind of exciting. Till then, farewell.